There's toxic blue poison littered throughout this beautiful red rock country. It's called blue asbestos, or chrysidolite, and over time has proven deadly.
I suppose there is a saying amongst us, the Aboriginal people, poison country, meaning bad country then.
The poison country has affected many across the decades, including Maitland himself.
I was diagnosed with mesothelioma in 2016, and it's a miracle I'm still here. It's my will keeping me going to fight this blasted thing. A lot of my people have been affected by it, have died from it as well.
When mining finished 60 years ago, the companies abandoned their leases and the masses of toxic contamination, leaving this part of Banjima country, known as Nambiganya or Wittenoom Gorge, too dangerous to enter.
Nambiganya Gorge itself is very significant to us. There's lots of sites in there and a lot of swimming holes where people used to recreate in the past. And now we can't get in there to do all that, any of that stuff.
Various companies mined here throughout the 1940s, 50s and 60s. But when they left, a loophole meant the tailings dumps were left to the WA government to clean up. It hasn't done this.
In those days, you know, they never spoke to any Aboriginal people. Nothing at all. They just got green light from government, signed on dotted lines, they can have their mines. That's the legacy that we're fighting as well, is what we're fighting for, to get it all changed for the better, not only for us Banjima people, but for everybody.
It's estimated that as much as 66,000 tonnes of blue asbestos was left behind in this vast 46,000 hectare area known as the Wittenoom Asbestos Management Area, close to the popular Karajini National Park. Maitland Parker has many stories to tell about the bad country, and that's what he wants to change.
As a kid, we used to go in and out of Wittenoom Gorge, walking all over all the tailings and up the catwalks and everything else, and pick all the tailings up and the asbestos and stuff like that. And so there's lots of stories. My cousins, my brothers, picking the blasted thing and putting it in their mouth and chewing it. And stuff. And so, you know, they're the things that we think about now for the younger generation, of course. If that happens to our younger mob, they're not going to last too long.
The Banjima people have been asking government to clean up the area for more than 10 years.
Get all these people, that the old miners of the place that made the mess, they got to bring them around the table and get them to put their hand in their pocket and help to clean it up. And so, yeah, it's going to cost millions, we know that, but hey, that's not our problem.
Joining their fight, an unlikely ally, the former boss of global miner Rio Tinto, Sam Walsh. Banjima have appointed him a director.
There is a need to clean up Wittenoom. It's an extraordinary situation. You know, coming from a mining company, I'm used to the expectation by the government and the community that you rehab and clean up as you go. But there's never been a clean-up.
There's a new sense of urgency. The point can reveal there are new contamination concerns outside the Wittenoom Asbestos Management Area.
We've received correspondence from the Department of Water basically identifying their concern with the pollution of waterways as a result of asbestos, and obviously they're seeking clean-up of that. But it clearly identifies that it is an area of concern for them, and it's a area of concern for us as well.
Maitland Parker says the government has no choice but to act. For too long, the contamination has been a blight on his people and his beautiful country.
We've had enough of it. We've seen too many of our people die from it. Not only my people, white people have died from it as well. And so, you know, so that legacy is what we want to fix and get the government to clean it up. It's simple, clean the place up is our message.